ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. أما بعد، إن شاء الله today we continue with الجواب الكافي or the sufficient reply، والدواء the disease and the cure by الإمام ابن القيم عليه رحمة الله تعالى. And today it is the beginning of the month of Safar. It's about, should be the third or the second of Safar according to the moon sighting. Allah knows best. I haven't checked that. And this is the 14th of the month of November 2015. And last time we went with Al-Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim alayhi rahmatullah through the long hadith that Al-Imam Al-Bukhari narrated, which contained some of the evil consequences of the sins or the punishments that some people will face in the fire. Then he started talking about the fact that sins and disobediences are the cause leading to the evil or the corruption that is found on earth. And he mentioned the ayah from Surah Ar-Rum 41, ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر, that the corruption has emerged, has become apparent on both land and sea. That is because بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِ النَّاسِ, that is because of what the hands of the people have earned. لِيُذِيقَهُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ, to make them taste some of what they have done so that they will go back, so that they will retract. And he mentioned the statements of the Mufassireen from Mujahid and Ikrima and Qatada. And this basically the people in the villages, the people in the Bedouin areas, the people of the countryside, the sins, because of these sins and disobediences that the people commit, then corruption has been spread in all of these areas. He mentioned that from Ibn Zayd, that's where we reached, that he said about ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر, he said الذنوب, that corruption has been spread or has emerged or has become apparent. He said الذنوب, the sins, يعني the sins. He said قلت أراد أن الذنوب سبب الفساد الذي ظهر. He said, he meant by this, Ibn Zayd, this Mufassir from the scholars of the past, he said that the corruption has emerged. He said the sins, meaning Al-Imam Al-Qayyim, he meant, he said that the sins are the cause leading to the corruption, the corruption that has emerged. He said, وَإِنْ أَرَادَ أَنَّ الْفَسَادَ الَّذِي ظَهَرْ هُوَ الذُّنُوبُ نَفْسُهَا فَيَكُونُ اللَّامُ فِي قَوْلِهِ لِيُذِيقَهُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا لَامْ الْعَاقِبَةِ وَالتَّعْلِيلِ. He said, now if he meant, one meaning he meant by that, that sins lead to corruption. But if he meant that the sins in themselves are the corruption, right? If he meant that the corruption that has emerged and became apparent, the corruption is actually those sins that have emerged and became apparent, then here Allah says after that, لِيُذِيقَهُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُ, so that he will make them taste. يعني this lamb here is, he's saying لام التعليل, the lamb of the cause, or and لام العاقبة, the lamb that leads to, that produces the end of, right? So here he said, according to the first explanation, then what is meant by corruption, يعني according to the first explanation, which means sins have led to corruption, sins have led to problems and chaos and all of that, right? So according to this first meaning, what is meant by corruption is النقص والشر والآلام, this deficiency, the evil and the pain, التي يحدثها الله في الأرض عند معاصي العباد, which Allah causes to happen on earth when the people commit sins. So that's the first meaning, people committing sins, because of these sins that they commit, Allah causes problems and chaos and deficiencies and sicknesses and so on and so forth because of these sins that they commit. فَكُلَّمَا أَحْدَثُوا ذَنْبًا أَحْدَثَ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ عُقُوبَةً, every time they start up, they initiate a sin, Allah initiates for them a punishment. كَمَا قَالَ بَعْضُ السَّلَفِ, as some of the pious predecessors said, كُلَّمَا أَحْدَثْتُمْ ذَنْبًا أَحْدَثَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانِهِ عُقُوبَةً, every time you initiate, you start committing a sin, Allah initiates and starts for you within His kingdom, from His kingdom, a punishment. Right? He said, وَالظَّاهِرُ وَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ, what is apparent and Allah knows best, أَنَّ الْفَسَادَ الْمُرَادُ بِهِ الذُّنُوبُ وَمُجَبَاتُهَا. What appears to Al-Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim here, he says that al-fasad here, corruption that is meant, corruption has been spread, has become apparent in the land and in the sea. That is because of what the hands of the people have earned. So that he will make them taste some of what they have done. This is the meaning of the ayah from Surah Ar-Rum once again. Right? He said what appears to be most correct to him is that this corruption that has emerged, what is meant by it is actually the sins themselves and the consequences of them, what they lead to and what they bring about. الذنوب, these are the sins. موجباتها, what they lead to, the consequences, the evil effects of the sins. All of that is corruption. He says, وَيَدُلُّ عَلَيْهِ, what proves that, what indicates that, قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى لِيُذِيقَهُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا, بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا, so that he will make them taste some of what they have done. Right? So what they have done is evil, so therefore he will make them taste evil. I'm fine, inshallah. Jazakallah khair. So what they have committed is evil sins. Therefore, the punishments, they get evil punishments. Evil sins, so evil punishments. And this is what has, this is the corruption that has emerged and became widespread and apparent in the land and also in the sea, everywhere. In the cities, in the villages, in the countryside, in the Bedouin areas, right? Evil sins lead to evil consequences, evil punishments. And this is the corruption that has emerged. The corruption then is the evil sins and the evil corruptions, or the evil corruption that happens because of them. Right? He says, عليه رحمة الله, فهذا حالنا. Then this is our condition, right? Yeah, this is between the 7th and the 8th century of the Hijrah, right? This is our condition. هذا حالنا. وإنما أذاقنا الشيء اليسير من أعمالنا. He only, سبحانه وتعالى, made us taste what is little of the deeds that we are doing. Right? He made us taste only a little, يسير. Right? يسير. This word يسير now showing up many times, right? Yesterday it showed up in the tafsir. Right? يسير. يسير. Which means like قليل, right? And the opposite is كثير. The opposite is كثير, a lot, right? يسير or قليل, it means a little. So he says he made us taste only the thing that is little, الشيء اليسير, the thing that is little of our deeds. فلو أذاقنا كل أعمالنا لما ترك على ظهرها من دابة. If he made us taste all of our deeds, يعني all of what we have done, meaning the consequences of what we have done, then he wouldn't have left on top, on the face of the earth, any moving creature, right? And this is the meaning of the ayat in the Quran and other places, that if Allah were to punish the people by all of what they have done, then they will be wiped out, right? These corruptions, these punishments, evil problems that happen on earth, this is only the taste of some of the evil that the people have committed, some of the sins that the people have committed. He said, وَمِن تَأْثِيرِ الْمَعَاصِ فِي الْأَرْضِ, and from the evil effects of sins on earth, ما يحل بها من الخسف والزلازل ويمحق بركتها. What happens on earth of this, the earth opening up and swallowing people. خسف, right? يعني a whole village disappears, right? Is being swallowed, just goes under. خسف. And زلازل, earthquakes. And محق البركة, يعني the blessings being completely erased, being completely taken away and removed and destroyed. The baraka is gone. وقد مر رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم على ديار ثمود. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم passed by the place, the lands of ثمود, where they were living. And this is in a hadith narrated by Imam al-Bukhari, hadith number 433, and Muslim hadith 2981. So when he passed by it, alayhi salatu wassalam, and this will come in the seerah, inshallah, later on. فَمَنَعَهُمْ مِنْ دُخُولِ دِيَارِهِمْ إِلَّا وَهُمْ بَاكُونَ. He prevented them from entering the lands of the people of Thamud, except while they are crying. وَمِنْ شُرْبِ مَائِهِمْ مِيَاهِهِمْ. He prevented them from drinking from the waters that were in that land, the land of Thamud. وَمِنَ الْإِسْتِقَاءِ مِنْ آبَارِهِمْ. And he prevented the Muslims from fetching or taking water from the water wells of that piece of land where Thamud used to live. حَتَّى أَمَرَ أَنْ يُعْلَفَ الْعَجِينُ الَّذِي عُجِنَ بِمِيَاهِهِمْ لِلنَّوَاضِحِ. To a point that he commanded, alayhi salatu wassalam, that the dough that was made by using their waters, yani some Muslims took flour and they made dough. Rasulullah sallam, he told them not to eat this dough. He said that it should be given as food to the camels, right? To the camels. They should not consume it. They should give it to the camels. لتأثير شؤم المعصية في الماء. He said, because of the evil effect of the sin, the evil effect of the disobedience, even in the water. Right? وكذلك تأثير شؤم الذنوب في نقص الثمار وما ترمى به من الآفات. Likewise, the evil effect of the sins in the deficiencies or the diminishment of the crops, the fruits, and what and the different kinds of problems, diseases that happen to those fruits and plants. Right? That is because of the sins of the people. The evil consequence of that reaches the fruit. He gives an example here. He mentioned that Imam Ahmad, he mentioned in his Musnad, this narration has weakness in it, but then it mentions something في ضمن حديث, as part of a hadith within, it was included in a hadith. So he mentioned the hadith and he mentioned this as part, you know, to be mentioned within it. قال وجد في خزائن بني أمية حنطة الحبة بقدر نواة التمر. He said that it was found in the treasures of Bani Umayya, the Umayyad period dynasty. حنطة, يعني wheat flour or the like, يعني grains. The one grain is in the size of a date pit. The one grain is in the size of a date pit. وهي في صرة مكتوب عليها هذا كان ينبت في زمن العدل. And that grain was enclosed, was wrapped up, and in that wrap or on that wrap it was written on it, يعني it's like a wrap or a bag, and they have the grain in it. A grain that is in the size of a date pit, and it was written on that bag. This used to grow in the time of justice. هذا كان ينبت في زمن العدل. These grains, they used to grow, they used to come out in the time of justice, right? When the rulers were just and fair, the people were fair to each other, then they had those grains that are in the size of a date pit. He said, وَكَثِيرٌ مِّنْ هَذِهِ الْآفَاتِ أَحْدَثَهَا اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى بِمَا أَحْدَثَ الْعِبَادُ مِنَ الذُّنُوبِ. Many of these, or most of these diseases that happen to the plants and the crops and the seeds and so on and so forth, Allah initiated because of what the servants have initiated, what they have started of the sins, right? وأخبرني جماعة من شيوخ الصحراء. This is Imam Ibn al-Qayyim now, he says, a group of old people from the desert, they told me, أنهم كانوا يعهدون الثمار أكبر مما هي الآن. أكبر مما هي الآن. Those old men from the desert area, they told the sheikh that they used to see the crops, the fruits and the crops, they used to be bigger than what they are now. That is in his time, right? That is in his time. يعني eight centuries ago, almost. He said, وكثير من هذه الآفات التي تصيبها لم يكونوا يعرفونها. And many or most of these diseases that happen, that happen to these crops, they used not to know these diseases before. وإنما حدثت من قرب. Rather, they just newly started, يعني close. يعني the time is close when these diseases, they were just newly happening, newly starting. right? And if they live to our time, then they will, يعني the many types of diseases that happen to the crops, يعني multitudes than what they know, يعني before. وأما تأثير الذنوب في الصور والخلق, as for the evil effects of the sins in terms of the images or the shape and the creation, فقد روى الترمذي في جامعه. This hadith is actually not in the Jami' of at-Tirmidhi, Allah knows best. It is in Bukhari and Muslim. And Imam al-Qayyim, he referenced it as such in other books of his, like Zad al-Ma'ad and others. So Allah knows, يعني, there is a mistake in here, either يعني, from the Imam himself or from those who wrote the book from him. Allah knows best. But anyways, the hadith is in Bukhari and Muslim that he said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, خلق الله آدم وطوله في السماء 60 ذراعا. Allah created Adam and his height is 60 arm spans up in the sky. فلم يزل الخلق ينقص حتى الآن. So the creation continued to diminish, to shrink and even go down, right, up to now, and gradually the creation started becoming more deficient and getting smaller and smaller, right? Otherwise Adam, when Allah created him, his height is like 60 arm spans. Imagine 60 arm spans. Hi, عليه الصلاة والسلام. He said, فإذا أراد الله أن يطهر الأرض من الظلمة والفجرة والخونة, if then when Allah wants to purify the earth from the oppressors, from the wicked, from the betrayers, يخرج عبدا من عباده, he will bring out a servant from his servants, من أهل بيت نبيه, from the family of his prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, فيملأ الأرض قسطا كما ملئت جورا. He will fill up the earth with justice and fairness as it has been filled with oppression. ويقتل المسيح اليهود والنصارى. ويقتل المسيح and the Messiah عيسى عليه الصلاة والسلام. He kills the Jews and the Christians. ويقيم الدين الذي بعث الله به رسوله, and he will establish the religion that Allah sent his messenger with. This is referring to the hadith that he does not accept al-jizya. He does not accept al-jizya. That Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, when he comes back, he will be ruling by the Islamic legislation, as he will not be coming as a new messenger. He will be coming back as a follower of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, and therefore he will establish his religion عليه الصلاة والسلام. And in the religion of Islam, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, as in the Quran, he سبحانه وتعالى legislated that the Jews and the Christians, they can remain to be Jews and Christians, but then they have to pay an amount of money to the Muslim ruler. Now when Isa alayhi salatu wasalam comes back, he will be not accepting the payment. And this is not a new legislation, it's in the hadith itself, you know, just in case you're saying he came as a follower of Muhammad ﷺ, how is it that he does not accept? Because it's in the hadith, it says that. In the hadith, it is legislated that he will not be accepting that, either Islam or to be killed. That's why he's saying he will be killing them here. He said, وَتُخْرِجُ الْأَرْضُ بَرَكَتَهَا. This is why he brought the hadith here, that the land, the earth, will bring out its blessings وتعود كما كانت, and it will go back as it used to be, يعني blessed, right? A blessed land. He said, حتى أن العصابة من الناس لا يأكلون الرمانة ويستظلون بقحفها, to a point that a group of people, they will eat one pomegranate, and they will take shade in its shell, يعني the cover of it, the cover of this, يعني the peel, the cover of the pomegranate. This is the what he meant by the قحف. قحف. They will take shade in that. Imagine how big this pomegranate is. يعني nowadays, you know, you buy pomegranate, يعني when you get big ones, mashallah, you say, like navel oranges or the likes of that. This is how big it is. But this one now, a group of people will eat from it, and they will take shade under its sky. يعني how big is this? It is so big of a fruit, right? ويكون العنقود من العنب وقر بعير. He said a bunch of grapes will be carried, will be carried by a camel. This is one bunch of grape will be put on the back of it. يعني to carry it, you need to have one camel to carry just one bunch of grapes. Imagine how big those grapes are, to a point that a bunch of grapes is so big, يعني you can only carry it on the back of a camel. He said, وَإِنَّ اللِّقْحَةَ الواحدة لتكفي الفئام من الناس. لقحة is the she camel that just gave birth, right? So now it has milk, right? So he says that one she camel that just gave birth, only one, it will be sufficient for groups of people. يعني groups of people, they will have milk, they will drink milk from one she camel. From one she camel. He said, وهذا لأن الأرض لما طهرت من المعاصي ظهرت فيها آثار البركة من الله التي محقتها الذنوب والكفر. That is because, he says, the earth, when it was purified of sins and disobediences, then the effects, the good effects of blessings, barakah, blessings, have emerged in it, have been apparent in it, from Allah, the barakah from Allah. This barakah that was completely wiped out, that was destroyed because of sins and disbelief, al-dhunub wal-kufr. So, basically, he's talking about towards the end of time, right? After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clears the earth from the sins and disobediences, and Isa alayhi salatu wasalam comes, and along with him are the believers, the obedient believers. So then the earth is purified, and therefore the blessings are back as they used to be, to a point that these fruits and the crops, they will be so big, and one she camel will provide sufficient milk for so many people. Why? The blessings are back again. Why? Because no sins and no disobediences. He said, وَلَا رَيْبَ أَنَّ الْعُقُوبَاتِ الَّتِي أَنْزَلَهَا اللَّهُ فِي الْأَرْضِ بَقِيَتْ آثَارُهَا سَارِيَةً فِي الْأَرْضِ تطلب ما يشاكلها من الذنوب التي هي آثار تلك الجرائم التي عذبت بها الأمم. He said that there is no doubt that the punishments that Allah sent down on earth, the evil effects of that remained and continuously remaining. Sariya, you know, they are continuously there, those punishments, the evil effects of them, they continued to exist. They continued to remain on earth, seeking the sins that are similar to them, right? Similar, the punishments that is similar or that is equal or that is a punishment that is equal or like the sin that was committed, as he will explain that a big sin will have a big punishment, a small sin will have a small punishment. So those sins that were committed before, they were punished by Allah. So the punishment for those sins, they continue to stay on earth, seeking the similar sins that they were sent as a punishment for, right? So those punishments which are the evil effects of those crimes, al-jara'im, those crimes which those nations were tormented with. He said, فهذه الآثار التي في الأرض من آثار تلك العقوبات. So these effects, these traces, things that are left, right, that are on earth, they are from the effects of those punishments. Exactly like those disobediences are from the effects of those crimes, right? Crimes and sins leading to punishments that are suitable to them. He said, فتناسبت حكمة الله وحكمه الكوني أولا وآخرا. So the wisdom of Allah matched and suited His universal command, His universal judgment, first and last, أولا وآخرا, right? Before and later on, right? His wisdom, subhanahu wa ta'ala, matched His universal ruling, right? He sent a punishment happening to the universe, right? Because of the sins of the people, right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished them. He said, وَكَانَ الْعَظِيمُ مِنَ الْعُقُوبَةِ لِلْعَظِيمِ مِنَ الْجِنَايَةِ. The greater punishment is for the greater crime. وَالْأَخَفُّ لِلْأَخَفُّ. And the lighter for the lighter one. Lighter punishment for the lighter crime. وَهَكَذَا يَحْكُمُ سُبْحَانَهُ بَيْنَ خَلْقِهِ فِي دَارِ الْبَرْزَخِ وَدَارِ الْجَزَاءِ. And likewise, Allah judges between His creation in the home, in the land, the place of Barzakh, and the place of reward. The place which is Al-Barzakh. Al-Barzakh is a place between two places, right? So we have now, we are in Dar al-Dunya, the worldly life. There is a Dar al-Akhirah, right? The last, the next life. And there is a life in between. That is the life in the grave, right? This is now called al-Barzakh, al-Barzakh, right? Because it separates between two things. Like in the Quran talks about and the salty water and the sweet water. If you have a river meeting a sea, then you have a barzakh in between. You have a separating part between them, right? That is called barzakh. In the Quran, it is called barzakh, right? So the life of al-barzakh, what is meant by it, the life in the grave up until the establishment of the hour. And it is generally from the next life, because you're not If you're dead, you're not in this life, right? But still the day of judgment didn't start. So people are in the graves up until the day of judgment. So that is the life of al-barzakh. He says the same judgment, the same ruling Allah gives for the people, like in this life. Lighter crime, lighter punishment. Severe crime, severe punishment. In the grave, in the same way. In the grave, it's the same way. Right? Lighter crime, lighter punishment. Heavy crime, heavy punishment. Likewise, in the next life, in the akhirah, in Jahannam, the same way. Lighter crime, lighter punishment. Severe crime, severe punishment. He said, وتأمل مقارنة الشيطان ومحله وداره. He said, examine, consider the companionship being with the shaitan, being with the shaitan, right? يعني the more you accompany, والعياذ بالله, he says, ومحله وداره, his place and his abode, right? If you are close, you are accompanying him, and accompanying him in his place or his abode, right? فإنه لما قارن العبد واستولى عليه نزعت البركة من عمره وعمله وقوله ورزقه. When he accompanied the servant and he took over him, the shaitan accompanied the servant and took over him, the blessings were snatched away, were taken away from his life, his action, his statement, and his provision. ولما أثرت طاعته في الأرض ما أثرت نزعت البركة من كل محل ظهرت فيه طاعته. He said, and when obedience to the shaitan brought an evil effect on the earth, whatever it has brought of an evil effect, then the blessings were snatched away, were taken away from every place in which his obedience, yani the obedience to the shaitan, has emerged. And likewise, his maskan, his place. You know, on earth, yani the more the people sin and disobey in a city, the more they will have trouble and punishments, right? He said, likewise, his home, when it is al-jahim, لما كان al-jahim, his last and final abode of the shaytan is jahannam, والعياذ بالله al-jahim. لم يكن هناك شيء من الروح والرحمة والبركة. In that place, which is the home of shaytan, there is nothing of relief, روح. There is nothing of mercy, and there is nothing of blessings. Right? Why? Because that is in the accompaniment, in the company of the shaitan, right? وَلَيَّذُ بِاللَّهِ. So those who are with and they accompany and they obey the shaitan in this worldly life, then they will be affected. They will have a negative, evil effect on them. And in the next life, it's the same. It's going to be the same way. Inshallah, we will stop here this time. Inshallah.